So, would you like to present our project, which was conducted here in our hospital? I'm Ana Carolina Peçanha Antônio. I'm a staff physician at the Adult Intensive Care Unit in Hospital de Clínicas de Porto Alegre. I'm part of the task force, a local task force created to discuss and implement the Choosing Wisely campaign at the hospital. It's a pleasure to be here with you, as I said before. I'd like to start my lecture with a hypothetical clinical case, which, of course, could be a real one. This 4-year-old male patient was admitted to the ICU with severe acute pancreatitis. He was on mechanical ventilation for 3 days. When he presented an acute worsening of his prior respiratory condition, it was 3 a.m. On physical examination, there was no evidence of significant change at that moment. Physician reported normal lung sounds and a profile lung ultrasound. As there was a completely normal chest X-ray taken early that morning as a matter of routine, a physician on duty decided not to order another one. Besides, portable X-ray equipment was running out of power since the machine had been used all day long. The patient's conditions deteriorated throughout that night. An important respiratory acidosis was observed, along with increasing doses of vasopressors. So early in the next morning, it was found that an intentional bronchial intubation had occurred. And on 10% of these cases, lung auscultation is completely normal. So endotracheal tube was gently withdrawn, and patient's condition dramatically improved. Oh, as has been already said, Choosing Wisely campaigns consists on global professional-led campaigns that oppose to low-value care, mainly characterized by underutilization and overutilization of healthcare resources, as to avoid missed opportunities in the care, as in the clinical case presented. The first call at the hospital level here occurred in November 2016, and thereafter, each surgical and medical department in the hospital selected three priorities to work on. In the ICU, we entirely based our three proposals on current SCCM recommendations. Instead of diagnostic tests, once that there has already been some recommendation from internal medicine department, we replaced it by chest X-ray exams. And in this very first phase, we joined the radiology department and elaborated this proposal in May 2017. Don't order chest X-ray exams at regular intervals, but rather in response to specific clinical questions. Then we had the hard task to make it real. We organized a task force composed by physicians from both ICU and radiology, technicians, nurse assistants, staff, and marketing coordinators to implement this Choosing Wisely recommendations. We aim to assess the current practice to identify potential interventions and potential barriers and enablers to this proposal. This was our flyer. Our initial goal was to decrease chest X-ray orders by 15%. This amount was modest compared to literature. We had data reporting up to 64% reduction at the time. And medical students, medical residents, staff physicians, and nurses from ICU attended to this first educational section, which took place on April 13, 2018. We had a medical surgical ICU in our hospital, which is divided in four major areas and is composed by 45 beds. Actually, a variety of scientific evidence favoring restrictive chest X-ray strategy on ICUs was already known by almost everybody. We just reinforced the whole idea, targeting in its safety in terms of mortality and duration of mechanical ventilation, as it's shown on this not so updated meta-analysis. And this more updated observational trial. The daily option from EMR system was removed on April 18th, 2018. From that time on, all other X-rays studies at ICU were considered urgent. That being said, maximum time to obtain images was within 2 hours. This change was extremely important. ICU physicians complained that availability of chest X-rays took a lot of time. And X-ray technicians, by their turn, claimed that the portable X-ray equipment required at least 4 hours to complete charge of battery, and overall hospital demands were way beyond their capability. We then performed the monthly data collection and program assessment, constant team contact by email, presential meetings scheduled at each 3 months, and a re-education section occurred on August in the same year, this year. So these are our preliminary results from May to October 2018. The average time to image acquisition was of 43 minutes. Our absolute numbers on chest X-ray had been decreasing since April to April 2017, showing an ongoing change in behavior. The ratio of chest X-ray per patient days showed a 20% reduction from 0.38 to 0.30 chest X-rays per patient days. This graph shows a comparison among months within same season of year. We expected higher number of chest X-ray orders in the winter months here in Brazil. And there was no increase of length of ICU stay after the campaign. We kept an average of 5 to 7 days of in length of ICU stay in our cohorts. So we have some limitations. Now, financial cost savings was extremely difficult to estimate because, just as labs, X-ray generates a downstream cascade on diagnostic and therapeutic procedures. This routine chest X-ray strategy has been also associated with higher adverse events, such as device removal and agitation, but we could not obtain this data. We aim to raise our goal to a 55% reduction, and we would like to review the indication of routine chest X-ray after US-guided procedures. It's our new plan for the next year, probably. I'd like to thank you, Dr. Rose Plotnik, Professor Dr. Thiago Garcia, Dr. Guilherme Barcelos, and Ana Paula Foletto. Here is not written, but Dr. Helena Barcelos helped us a lot as well. And we aim what is written here, all the care and only the care that will help the patient. Thank you very much.